Hello everybody, Alex Aployo from Expert Forex, and welcome to today's review of the market. On your screen you can see last week's review, and the market has taken quite a change since last week's review. Last week, and I encourage you to go and watch this video from last week's analysis, we had a trending market and we discussed various strategies on how to enter a trending market. Now this week, we have a completely different market. We have a consolidating market, and your strategies need to change to adapt to that changing market. So we're going to look at two strategies on how to deal with consolidating markets. So how do I know that the market is consolidating? And I'm going to show you two ways that I can very quickly visually see that. And the first way is using the 360 degree indicator and looking at the RSI, and what you will see is that on the weekly RSI, there are a lot of overboughts and oversolds. Look at those colors. There's a 13 and a 90. Lots of overbought and oversold readings on the weekly. But on the daily and the 4 hour, we have readings that are sort of in the middle of the market. In fact, you can see there's no overboughts or oversold. Now that shows you that in the longer term charts, the market is still relatively trending, but in the short term, the market is actually consolidating. It's got no momentum, because that's what RSI measures, is momentum. It's got no momentum. It's drifting around in a sideways way. So let's go and have a look at some of the charts to see if that the charts confirm that. Now, my favorite charts for telling the phases of the market are the multiple moving average charts that you can see on the screen. And on the screen, you can see the daily multiple moving average charts. And let's have a look at them. And how I know the market is consolidating is when the width of the difference between the moving averages is getting smaller. So for instance, you see how fat the width is there, and look how it's getting smaller. Look how fat the width is, and it's getting smaller. And in fact, it's consolidating quite severely there. And the same thing here, wide but consolidating, wide consolidating. Even here, it looks like there's a nice uptrend, but it is in fact consolidating. And the same thing here, downtrend but consolidating, uptrend but consolidating, downward trend, but look how it's consolidating over here. And so on, and we get the whole market is consolidating. Look at that, it's going down, it's uptrend but consolidating, uptrend but consolidating, uptrend but consolidating. I'm starting to sound like a broken record, but that's true. Uptrend and consolidating. And here you can see a beautiful consolidation. It's even changing trend. Now, how do I know it's changing trend? Is when the fast moving average crosses over the slow moving average, then we have a trend change. So it's almost changing trends there. Again, consolidation there, consolidation there, and consolidation there. So visually, the multiple moving averages are fantastic for immediately showing you what's going on in the market. Now, these are the daily charts, so let's have a look at the 4 hour ones. Okay, now yeah, we see quite an interesting situation. So although the markets are consolidating, there is a bit of movement, but there's still a good consolidation there. Here you actually see a change of trend. The fast is moving over the slow, and we are looking at a potential downward trend, a potential downward trend there, potential downward. Very strong consolidation. Now, we were talking about how do you trade a consolidating market. And when you see the moving averages pinching to the point that they're almost making one color, you see they almost make one color, that is the point where the market has reached a level of total indecision. Now, let me explain that. So the long-term traders, represented by the long-term moving average, and the short-term traders, represented by the short-term moving averages, are all at the same place. So they are as confused as each other. They say, in the long-term, I think the market's going nowhere. In the short-term, the market's going nowhere. And that's how they all land up in the same place. That's why these multiple moving averages are so good. They give you the long-term view and the short-term view at the same time. So when the long-term and the short-term view is uncertain, then they consolidate. opposed to when it's trending. You can see when the market's trending up there like that, there's certainty in the market. The long-term and the short-term guys are all saying, oh, there's a trend in place, and look at them, they're all pointing in the same direction. Fantastic confirmation. There's certainty in the market. And then suddenly all that certainty disappears and they start consolidating. You say, oh, we don't know where to now. And they start consolidating until the slightest bit of news will disrupt that balance. And that's what you trade, is that disruption. So let's have a look. Here's the USD yen. It's highly consolidated. How do you trade that? Well, one easy way of doing that is actually just straddling the market. So let's have a look. So what you do, okay, so what you do is you say there's one level, and let's put another level there, and you straddle the market. So what we know, and if we look at this chart of the euro yen, when it consolidates like that, the slightest bit of news will make a trend. So that what we want to do is we want to straddle the price so that the slightest bit of news just takes us with us. So we put a pending order, and you can put it a lot tighter than that, a pending order just above and just below the price, and you straddle the price. You say, I don't know where it's going. The market itself doesn't know where it's going because everybody's uncertain. So you straddle it, and when that suddenly the certainty returns, the market will take you with it. So you stand in the way of the market, and you'll just let it take you. So that's one way of trading a consolidating market. Okay, so now the other way of dealing with that consolidating market is to look at the multiple time frame approach. So on your screen, you can see those same multiple moving averages, but this time I've got them on the weekly, daily, 4 hour, 1 hour, and 15 minute charts. So what you start looking at is you say, oh, look on the weekly, there's an element of certainty. Look, it's all of them are sort of pointing up, most of them, not all of them, but there is a bit of a consolidation at the top. But on the weekly, the bias is still upwards. Then you look at the daily and you say, okay, yes, overall the bias is still upwards, but it seems to be resting. And the question is it ledging, or is it going to reverse? And remember from last week, ledging is something like that and something like that. So we're saying, okay, we're not sure if this is a ledge yet or not, but what we can do is you can use normal support and resistance, and you can start saying, okay, if it violates that line, which is a non-horizontal support and resistance line, I want to sell. So you're not straddling it with horizontal lines, you're straddling it with non-horizontal lines, or you say if it breaks out of that non-horizontal support and resistance, you want to trade it. But our bias is still up. You see, it's still up. So the chances are you want to actually buy this one. So we look at the 4 hour, we say, oh, the 4 hour, same thing, we can draw a support line there, or we can draw a resistance line up here, and we can say, all right, we want to trade. So it's still a form of straddle, but the bias, because the weekly's still up, the daily's still up, the bias is still upwards. So that's your point of entry. And if you want to refine your point of entry even more, here's the way to do it. You go to the 1 hour, and now you have a refined support and resistance line that you want to use. And resistance line, so you're refining your entry. So can you see if that breaks, you'll actually still be in between those two lines, but you're refining your entry even more. And if you drill down to the 15 minutes, you can refine your entry even more. So it depends on what kind of risk you prepare to take, but certainly there's a resistance line. If that's broken, certainly it looks like it's gonna, and especially with that strong consolidation there, it will break in a big way, and you want to be in there. And then some traders would say, look, I'm going to hedge my bets, I'm going to straddle it this way, and I'm going to take the buy or the sell, no matter which way it goes, let the market decide where the price will go. So you use the multiple time frame one, to just confirm what you're seeing in the market. There's still a bullish bias here, so you can treat this almost like a ledge and trade it as a ledge, like I am there, upwards, so that the bias is still upwards because of the overall trend. But certainly you're not ignoring the possibility of a downward break by doing a non-horizontal straddle. So the last two sessions have been quite interesting. The first one was how to trade trends, and the second one is how to trade sideways markets. So I hope you've enjoyed this analysis, and I hope you've learned something from it, and I look forward to next week's analysis. From me, Alex DePloy, cheerio.